It's often easy to forget that behind every scientific endeavor, there's a story. But this story of Dr. Ray Weil and his Brassica research team at the University of Maryland surely is one of the best.
In South America, for a variety of reasons, their no-till revolution had cover crops front and center. Whereas in the United States, the no-till revolution started out with cover crops. If you look at the old extension bulletins from the 70s, yes, cover crops were recommended.
Yes.
But pretty quickly, the no-till revolution in the United States really became about leaving dead crop residue on the surface. And so when American scientists and American farmers went down and looked at the no-till being practiced in Brazil and Paraguay and Argentina, they saw that cover crops were really important. It was a key part of how they did their no-till, and they saw lots of brassica cover crops. So my master's advisor, Ray Weil, went down and came back really inspired that there is a future for cover crops in the United States, and the resistance might be overcome by using more brassicas.
Oh.
So he put together a team of graduate students, a brassica cover crop research group.
Yes.
And that's certainly not the only reason why brassicas became exciting to scientists and farmers, but that group played an important role. It brought cover crop seed, radish seed in particular, to people like Steve Groff,
yes,
who of course has done amazing things with tillage radish. It also, it was a comprehensive look, so we had people looking at nitrogen scavenging,
yes,
nitrogen release, nutrient effects beyond nitrogen, such as phosphorus availability, and the nematode story. My late wife did a project where she investigated the nematode effects, and she didn't just look at the pest nematodes, the plant parasitics, she looked at the whole community.
Yes.
So there was a really comprehensive look at how brassica cover crops impact soil systems.
Okay.
And Ray Weil was instrumental in assembling that team.